As far as the chaos we find ourselves in these days, it's difficult to say which side pulled the trigger first. Arugia deployed an automatic intercept system with drones. Osea implemented long-range attacks to bypass them. So Arugia decided to sabotage Osea's communications and navigation technology. Arugia couldn't launch a satellite themselves, but they were still able to hack the software of the Osean transmission and navigation systems. Before Osea even noticed, half of their satellites were hijacked. That's when things got ugly. In an attempt to knock out each other's capabilities, both forces launched fighters loaded with anti-satellite missiles at the same time. Only military satellites were targeted. However, their destruction created a debris field in orbit, which wiped out scores of other satellites, both private and government-owned. What kept the world relatively sane up to that point had been free-flowing data and information. But now, those were gone. All that remained was chaos and confusion. Government and civilian broadcasts and transmissions were cut off. The flow of information had ceased. Forces on both sides of the conflict now found themselves unable to communicate with their superiors. Many of the smaller countries annexed by Arugia and yearning for their independence seized the opportunity and started their own uprisings. As for why some of Osea's military decided to break off from the main force and continue on their own, I have no idea. Perhaps there was some sort of dispute over the chain of command. The continent that had once seen wars that were only fought between Osea and Arugia was now full of numerous conflicts between rival leaders vying for power. Insurgencies were everywhere. I even heard a rumor that a group of Osean convicts had rebelled. Rumors. It never ceased to amaze me that even at a crazy time like this, something as trivial as a rumor could find its way here. Communications from corporate were cut off. Apparently, the entire computer network was down. It was a wise decision to make our drones autonomous with AI instead of being radio-controlled. Wise and forward-thinking. Even with their GPS offline, they can still use their sensors to navigate as long as they're working properly. I'm sure the drones are still working perfectly, following their mission orders to the letter. I wish I could upload Mihai's new data to them. But without a connection, I can't upload the software to the active drones. The new ones we're making, though, there should still be enough time to upgrade those before they're activated. I'll be taking the data I've acquired away from the front lines now. Oh, and I'll be taking the girls, too. I told my assistant, Masa, it was time to get Mihai's granddaughters ready to leave here. She's not much older than the girls, but she has a way about her, and I'm sure she won't have any trouble with them. I saw a plane flying off in the distance. I imagine it was looking for a safer place. The plane had a rose emblem on it.
Arugia's communication networks have been down since their satellites were destroyed. Unfortunately, we are experiencing trouble too. All of Arugia has been affected, and we don't know when things will be back up and running. We're not even sure if this is Arugia's doing. Still, we will follow the strategy that was originally planned and move on to the next operation after liberating Farbanti. Let's get to it. Since the war began, we've been receiving communications in secret from an officer in the Arugian army. With the capital under our control, Arugia's radical element is losing support quickly, affecting the balance of power. HQ is thinking of using the military officer as a way to gain leverage to settle peace negotiations. The officer is currently hiding in the outskirts of Anchorhead Bay, having joined up with support dispatched from the Osean army. The plan is that they'll take a standard vehicle to a rendezvous point at a harbor in the east part of the city, where a helicopter will be waiting. I would like the new Strider Squadron to provide escort for the officer. Cyclops will remain at the base on standby to serve as defense.
With the communication network currently down in the capital, I very much doubt Arusia will be able to mount a regimented counterattack. However, it is likely that Arusia's intelligence department and the remaining forces who are aware of the officer's movements will interfere. Keep a close eye on the officer and make sure he stays safe. Our victory in Farbanti has given us a golden opportunity to finally end this war. Be safe out there.
Take note that our satellite-based IFF has become unreliable following the recent communications failure. As such, target ID will be done by processing the images from the infrared cameras on your aircraft. Objects will initially appear as unknown on your HUDs, but will be ID'd once you close in on them for a set period of time.
The unidentified Ocean craft. This is Captain Carl of the Ocean Army. Are you here for the escort?
You're not the squadron I was expecting.
Are you really friendlies? Over.
This is Longcaster. Airborne warning and control system for the Ocean Long Range Strategic Strike Group. Captain Carl, they're on our side.
And those two pilots we've heard about must be here too.
Okay, I hope you're right.
Longcaster, are all of these really unknowns?
It's a state of civil war. The Erosian army is fighting itself. There's no guarantee the Oceans won't shoot us in this confusion.
We'll image process the unknowns caught in your cams to identify friend or foe. The process will be faster if you get a close-up, well-centered image.
Meanwhile, we just run if they shoot us, right?
Affirmative. Always identify your target before you fire.
Something I'll never get used to. Tonight has been a total shock. The city under martial law. Gunfire and the roar of jets echoing from the streets.
Give me Strider Squadron's IDs. Oh, and hand me that sandwich. Beat on you. It's ID'd as Erosian.
Wait. General Mattis has convinced them.
Listen, those that protect General Labarth are the real patriots. Onward!
There's a vehicle up ahead. Think it's gonna ask us to pay a toll? Get closer and find out if it's an enemy vehicle.
We'll go. Let's go.
We archived all the footage that we've shot when the communication networks come back online.
There's a vehicle blocking the road. No response to hails. It's the radicals.
Signs of the clean warfare at the beginning of this war are now gone. Strutter 1, missile launched.
Nice work. That takes care of that one. We're heading for the highway. Thanks to you. Got out of paying that toll.
I'll wait before firing. Bail out now. Field's one stuck. Check your IFF. It's a friendly. I know what I'm doing.
We're almost at landfill number 7. If we can make it through, we'll be in arm's reach of the rendezvous at Kruger Park.
Captain Carl, do you have the means to record this conversation? I wish to explain to you the situation inside Erugia. I'm sure the boys listening upstairs will record it. The open declaration of war, expanding the front lines, was all the work of some young Erugian officers. They were referred to as the Radicals. There was an unseen force guiding them. It was technology they borrowed from the Belkans. When they actually went to war, the performance of the attack drones exceeded their wildest dreams. And they were incredibly clean, which got public opinion and the opportunists within the military on their side. Even with the gun and the princess. The Belkan technology advanced UAV research within the Erugian flight test center by at least 10 years. They used the flight data from a former ace pilot to create drone AI, but to us it's no different than magic or alchemy. Airplanes are meant to be flown by human beings. For those of you listening in, am I wrong?
We're heading towards Gruner Park. Rendezvous point is the helipad on this man-made island. We'll ditch the car and take the helicopter from there.
Members of the military are calling itself free Erugians. An unknown is blocking our scheduled route.
No response. Got a pad for you.
Forces, take it out!
Trigger, the VIP
Watch out for enemy ambushes.
Understood. System failures caused friendly fire incidents among Ocean forces. There are even rumors of penal units turning on their former allies. Attack the civilian liaison.
Ammunition zero.
What?
They could be Ocean fighters. ID them ASAP. ID complete. They're Ocean fighters. What the hell is going on?
Stay sharp.
Uh-huh.
Right. I'm shooting them down. Any complaints?
Granted.
Welcome.
Yeah, good work. Strider 1 has killed a bandit.
Safe. Wait.
The escort fighter is... the drive. They're missing the drive.
What the hell? You gotta be kidding me. Liaison escort has a radar lock. They're targeting you guys.
What the hell? We were just helping them.
Arusian aircraft, this is AWACS Longcaster. Do not engage the liaison. Break off now.
Can you hear me on this channel, Ocean craft? Those escort aircraft are drones. They are currently being operated autonomously. They are not being controlled by anyone. They are flying on their own volition. What?
In that case, we have no choice but to shoot the aircraft down.
Unfortunately, yes.
Nicole.
We did what we could.
Nicole.
Weapons free. We're cleared to attack the escort.
Welcome.
Understood.
Welcome.
The MQ-99's launch! Our commands are overridden!
They must be accessing it remotely.
Hey, it's not our fault they won't listen to reason. Why build something like that? Whoever did is the king of all dumbasses. Additional hostiles inbound.
Nicole.
Great timing.
Nicole.
Son of a bitch.
Nicole.
story to tell my boy. Understood. All hostiles have been eliminated. Nice. The General's helicopter is flying safely outside Anchorhead Bay. All aircraft, RTB, mission complete.
All hostiles, huh?
General, the Ocean aircraft is here to pick us up. The approaching Ocean aircraft.
Losing his army? Elaborate. They stole our sealed orders. It should be a piece of cake.
Are you sent by the General's staff? No.
There are three scratches.
What does that mean?
The tail of that plane.
In order to respond to the attack on the base, Cyclops has scrambled after being on standby. We'll head up too, once our planes are ready. Oh, and Labarth is dead.
What did you say?
Apparently, he was shot down by another Ocean aircraft after he left the area of operations. I mean, I know it was chaos, but still. At any rate, the sealed order operation has come to a close. We have no idea about a plan for going forward.
All we can do for now is watch our own backs.
What's up with the commander?
He's staying in his room. He's still alive, since we can hear him crying.
The island we went to was supposed to have been secured by the ground forces. They hadn't gotten a handle on things by the time we got there, so now we were stuck in the middle of a half-assed campaign. My job was to get the planes ready for combat, making repairs and handing them over to our troop of cons. Thing is, the enemy still had the hangars. The comms were still down, so none of us knew what the hell was going on. The last transmission I heard before everything went to shit was that some prisoners from an Ocean military penal unit rioted and managed to escape. They stole some jets and now they were flying around, taking out their former allies left and right. I wonder if any units like ours were out here, creeping around. Hearing the Ocean jets firing at each other overhead chipped away at morale. Since the radio was out, it was quiet. I liked it better that way. All I heard was the gunfire. Here we were, walking around carrying rifles. We were pilots, damn it. Friendly fire will probably kill us. You know things are desperate when the guards that used to lock us into solitary are now telling us it's better we all stick together. I guess they think our odds of surviving this war are better that way. After walking for miles across the battlefield, we came across the wreckage of a plane. Passenger, not military. I knew that Rose. It was an Erujian liaison plane. The guard's dogs smelled something and took off. They led us to a cliff. And the bodies.
Today, I lost everything. When Osea attacked our capital, my father, a man who was never really suited to being the king, was killed. I was to be flown out of the war zone to safety, but the plane was shot down by rebels. The entire crew was killed in the crash. Soldiers appeared and one shot at me. My dog went after him and I shot him to pieces. He was my best friend. After all those speeches I gave, about working together for peace. I thought everyone felt the same as I did. I'm sure the soldier who shot at me knew I was the princess of Erujia. He was Erujian too. More soldiers have come. Now, there is no one left to protect me. I am so numb, I cannot move. I watch as one of their dogs approaches. It sniffs mournfully at my dead friend. I wonder if it grieves for him as much as I do. I can barely think. I feel weaker by the minute. I don't know who these soldiers are with, but I managed to take a sip of the water they gave me.
How long have you been here?
Somehow, I muster the courage to answer the woman's question. I tell her I've been there 3 days. They gather around me with grim looks on their faces. What would they do if they knew I was the Erujian princess? After searching the cockpit of the plane, the woman who spoke to me before came back to me.
This is an air-to-ground tactical radio. It still works!
I noticed she walked with a limp. She knelt down next to me and asked her companions to give me some food. And then, very softly, she said,
"You see, I used to listen to your broadcasts, Your Royal Highness."
Just what did you see here?
Okay, enough talk. Your opinions have all been taken into consideration. Beyond the seizure of Forbanti, which is important, and supporting the Erujian officer, at this point, I just don't know what our strategy is, or what our mission will be. Radio communication is still patchy for both the military and civilians, so we're getting zip from Mission Command about our orders. Still, with countless Erusian forces in the area, it's too dangerous for us to stay around here waiting for a miracle. Now, regarding Count's suggestion to think about self-defense, I think we should make a break for Tyler Island. It was a large Ocean base before the start of the war. Count says his previous squadron took part in an operation to seize control of the island. It has the only base that will get us to the space elevator without refueling. It's also a transport facility for supply ships that provide drones and ammo for arsenal birds. For the Ocean forces that are looking to reclaim the space elevator, those are two great reasons in its favor. If everything went according to plan, the base may already be in Allied hands when we get there. Though based on what Count told me about the island operation, it won't be easy to seize control.
If the ground troops have managed to open the bridgehead, the transport route to Nosia for supply ships should be available.
So much at stake, I can't imagine Arusia just giving it up without a fight. Things could really have gone bad.
Even if there are enemies left, they should be pretty easy to suppress.
I just want to go home, man.
Me too.
With that look on your face, Trigger, I know exactly what you want to do.
If Trigger's ready to kick ass, then so am I.
Damn straight. We're with you, Trigger.
It's decided then. Let's get all the aircraft and haul ass to Tyler Island. Although we can avoid the Arsenal Bird's anti-air network, there's still remnants from the Erusian forces. I want to get to the island without getting into any unnecessary combat. Pick a fast craft and fix it how you want. Pack for a long trip, but remember, if you drag your ass, you'll get left behind.
I can guess what happened here, but I really don't want to think about it.
From the east.
Their timing tells me they're not here to bring good news.
We need to ID the bogeys. Take them down if they're hostile.
Understood.
Yeah.
Control, roger that.
Warning, enemy has a bead on you.
Missile. Good job! The enemy can't shoot them! I don't think I can even do anything!
I heard it from an Erosian soldier that defected. The supply ships will be launched soon.
Yeah, that is valuable information.
That doesn't sound good.
But can it be trusted?
Not sure. Heard it from a man who said he wanted to atone for his sins. Up to you to trust him or not.
Understood. Good luck.
Releasing safety.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Launch. 1, 2, 3. The mass driver is accelerating.
The supply ships have been launched from the mass driver. If the supply ships make it to the arsenal bird, they'll be able to resupply it. They may be loaded with new weaponry that we don't even know about. We have no choice but to take down the supply ships before they can get within the Arsenal Bird's air defense network. You've got to hurry or you're not going to make it. 3 minutes to the enemy's air defense network.
I was expecting this to be easy if all they could do was fly fast.
All aircraft, remain on high alert. We got bandits incoming on radar. I have to forget about him for now. Focus on destroying that supply ship first.
We're sitting ducks like this.
If we let the supply ship get too far away, we'll never be able to catch it. The target's using cloud cover to hide itself. Don't worry, we know where it's heading.
That's a confirmed direct hit by the missile. Keep it up. Bring down those supply ships. Warning, enemy has a bead on you. 90 seconds to the enemy's air defense network.
Don't lose them! Did you see that explosion? Looks like that's one of them down.
Remember, there are two supply ships out there. Hurry up and shoot the other one down.
Enemy on your back!
We've recalculated the remaining time. 60 seconds remain.
Don't overshoot.
Box 2! Let me slide in on that tail.
Hope you're all enjoying the pretty fireworks. This thing had any windows, we could have seen it for ourselves. Nice work, team.
We're gonna find ourselves a boat and leave this island. We'll be taking the refugees, along with any deserters from the Erosian military.
Who's the girl that ran into tanks with the smoke canister? A few more crazies like her, and life down there may have been a tad bit easier.
What do you think would have happened to those refugees if you hadn't intervened? The princess saw what happened. They were little kids.
That's why I like the sky. You don't have to see those types of things.
Does this mean we're that much closer to ending the war?
No, we just basically prevented it from going on forever.
Count's right. We have no choice but to return to our original base. Our base that is nearly out of food and fuel. We need to do something.
Good. Take a seat. Everyone's here. All right. Good work in sinking the supply ships. Not to mention saving the refugees. However, we're in no position to start celebrating. Even the commander here is starting to fray from the stress.
Can't say I blame him.
Now, Tyler Island is in a state of complete anarchy. This base isn't safe either. The faces you see around you are the only friends we've got. Take a good look.
We found a boat, then sailed away from the island. We had to. We didn't belong there. The new guy's name was George. I noticed when the anarchist said his name, he said it with a thick Belkan accent.
How did you know that he was from Belka?
Well, both my parents were from Belka, so...
You never told me that. They say that Belkans are known for their conspiracies.
That's just a stereotype. Now, I simply stated my honest opinion and was thrown in jail for it.
The princess sat there looking miserable. That was a dumbass stunt she pulled back there, but it got us on this boat.
Take a look at that. This ship is heading for a single rope that's hanging down from the sky. Do you know how far the end of that rope reaches? Outer space. No. It is a direct connection to the very potential of mankind itself. Or at least it was until war erupted. It's my strong belief that the rope might be connected to a very distant, faraway source of great conflict and strife. Even long before the war, the whole world started falling apart once Harling began trying to build it. I often wonder what was going through Harling's mind when he was trying to destroy the very thing that so many people were sacrificed in order to create.
Sacrificed? What do you mean?
Have you seen all of those countless old space shuttles on Tyler Island that are no longer in use?
Yeah. I always thought of them as a good source of scrap. They're an obsolete technology that was abandoned during the construction of the space elevator. Which would mean that if the space elevator was destroyed, it would be that much harder for mankind to reach the stars. Until we find another way.
But even then, Harling still went ahead and tried to destroy it. At the cost of his own life.
That's not the way I heard it. What I heard was that he sacrificed himself to protect the tower from an incoming missile.
Oh, I was told he tried to fly his ship into the tower in order to destroy it.
I wonder which story is true, Your Royal Highness.
I don't know. Looking at it objectively, it's reasonable to believe that Harling had both options before him.
When it comes to which one you think he took, I guess it's like a mirror.
Yes, it is. It's like a mirror looking into your own soul, based on whichever choice you believe it was. At the moment, though, I can only see darkness. I think that thing should be destroyed.
It's time for the briefing. Although, since we don't have any contact with HQ, it's not like this is an official mission. Anyway, it looks like the seizure of Tyler Island and the relief from Osea have been postponed. In the meantime, we just have to do what we can to survive. Since losing its capital city of Ferbanti, Eurusian forces have separated into smaller, autonomous factions. It looks like Eurusia's largest force and leading faction will pass through the area around this base. The space elevator is significant to them, so they're probably heading there.
Should we intercept?
Why? I doubt they're gonna start a fight now.
Our top priority should be to get home. Let's go already.
Yeah. It's not like we have the supplies, power, or even a real reason to put up a fight. But what are we going to do if they bring the fight to us? We need to be ready to push them back. If we head inland from here towards Arusha, there's an old castle that's been converted into a stockpiling base, Shilaji Castle. It's currently occupied by some of the Arusian forces that broke off, but we need ammo and fuel. They appear to have converted a freeway into a runway, so we can expect them to have the capacity for air combat. But they'll be easier to handle than Arusha's lead faction. But we can't use all our aircraft to attack. The transport carrying the stolen supplies needs support. Okay, Strider Squadron. You head out first and neuter the dogs at the stockpiling base. Rendezvous with Cyclops Squadron, who will bring the transport. Then we bring the supplies back to this base.
Got it.
Aircraft are our only threat.
Sounds good.
We'll make it. We're all gonna fly home together.
Ocean forces are in the region ahead. No allies here. No need to ID your target. We've set a number of priority targets, focusing on their anti-aircraft weaponry. Okay, team. Into work.
Unidentified aircraft. Not sure if friend or foe. Fire anyway. We don't have time to be wondering if they're friendlies or not.
So, we capture this base and take the fuel and supplies. That's the plan, right, Trigger?
You take if you want to live. That's how it was where I grew up.
I was just double-checking mission orders, Hooshin.
Our anti-air guns are destroyed! Abandon and fall back to our rear position! Retreat!
There are more vehicles along the road. They don't appear to be military. They're Arusian refugees. Must be fleeing since the conflict got worse.
Unidentified aircraft! Identify at once or we're on fire!
Talking about? They already are firing on us. The enemy's confused. I know.
We're all out of ammo. Don't give up. We're not going to lose our country again.
So what's this faction split from the Arusian military?
The autonomous state of Shilaji used to be a nation. The region has always leaned towards independence. Those who want to restore their homelands flock to it. Apparently. Their corps consists of officers from Vosovich, which neighbored Shilaji.
Are they our enemies?
They're our enemy's enemy, but not our friends.
They're destroyed. We're unable to use the SAMs!
The resistance is strong. They seem pretty desperate.
Coming up on the castle.
Let's hurry up and capture this base so we can get its fuel and supplies.
Shit! I feel like we're a group of burglars.
Don't say that. This is for our survival.
Yeah, I know.
They have four aircraft! Four planes incoming! Fire more missiles!
That's Shilaji Castle.
They're here already.
Carry on. Quick, do it!
Set up AA weapons.
hostiles. All aircraft confirmed. This town's of high cultural value. It's unfortunate we had to bomb it like we did.
We do what we need to survive, right?
Not something I'll tell my son about.
Cancel takeoff. Soul Squadron, stand by.
Negative. This battle's over if we don't get up there. Along with hope of restoration. Don't worry. As long as we accelerate inside the tunnel, they won't be able to shoot us down that easily.
Their interceptors are in the air.
All right.
Getting to takeoff speed inside the tunnel is insane.
Soul Squadron, airborne. Shoot the invaders out of our skies.
Nicole.
Come on, Soul Squadron.
Understood.
Nicole.
You are in violation of Shiraji airspace. Turn around and look for us to shoot you down.
Nicole.
This is the OCN Long Range Strategic Strike Group. Land immediately and hand over your planes and base to us.
You must be the Snowbirds.
Nicole.
It's absurd for you to be talking so tough after losing one of the leaders at Barbanti.
Nicole.
You bastard!
Nicole.
You defile this country.
Nicole.
As long as you are here, this country will never know peace. Shit.
Nicole.
I'm out! Ejecting!
Nicole.
I hope he's okay. Bailing out under those conditions. I can see his parachute. Let's pray he makes it to safety.
Three to go. Don't let them work together. Back up Trigger. Wilco.
I know.
Caution.
Target locked. Don't let them get under your skin. Strata 1, Fox 2. Strata 1, target acquired.
Nicole.
Enemy on your back. Speed projectile launch from the aircraft.
I'm testing this aircraft. You must find your own sky. We can still help you. Don't waste your life. Dedicated to reclaiming that which you call home. Furthermore, we must find someone to guide you. I am not that person. Mihai. Los Legion Squad will be retreating. Those spreading below are advised to temporarily withdraw.
Okay.
Enemy has a bead on you.
Missile.
Strider 1 scored another hit.
It's a hit. The unidentified aircraft is going down.
He got him. Trigger is splashed a bandit.
Can you hear me? Pilot with the three strikes. This was all due to my ego. I unleashed pure chaos upon this world, just so I could keep my wings. Put a stop to the drone production.
Is this a message to Trigger? What does it mean?
I don't think this war is over just because we shot down Mr. X. Yeah, it's gonna take something else entirely to end this thing. I just don't know what.
The resupply went well. We should be okay on food and fuel reserves for a little while at least. Luckily, the rumor that the Arusian army is advancing nearby is only a rumor. There's no sign of them from the skies.
Rumors.
Rumors, rumors. This is what happens when you lose communications. But we got one good fact. The plane Trigger shot down was an advanced model of the XO2 Wyvern. It was developed in the last Continental War. Erugia had a lot up their sleeves. Apparently, they were even supposed to have Belkan aircraft back in the First War. What if Trigger couldn't shoot it down? Just thinking about it gives me chills. We're lucky to be here. In war, you never know what's lurking behind the curtains. But it looks like everything's loose now. Solid chain of command, rest periods after sorties, a battlefield where you know friend from foe. All of that's gone now, lost in a fog of confusion. Feels like a distant dream. Now, just how the hell are we gonna get out of this mess?
When we got to the mainland, we found the space elevator's support facility. I guess this was the factory where they built the gigantic structure the elevator traveled in. There was this little girl sitting in front of a mural. When the princess saw her, she shuddered like she'd seen a ghost. The girl had a stuffed animal. This was the day after the shit went down at Tyler Island. She walked right up to the princess, took her hand, and led her into the factory. One thing's for sure, they knew each other. The factory'd been converted to a production line for Arusian drones. It was fully automated and chugging along, making drone after drone after drone. Once they got inside, the princess stopped and just stood there. Another girl was there with a man in a lab coat. He was trying to use his keyboard, but she wouldn't let him. She took a data chip and threw it on the ground. Then she walked over to us and took the gun from the prison guard's holster. She pulled the trigger and destroyed the chip. Later, I found out that the girl with the gun and the one with the stuffed animal were sisters. They were also the granddaughters of Mihai A. Shilaji, the legendary pilot. Gramps used to talk about him. He said Mihai was the top ace from two wars ago. Know any Belkans? Because this guy was a Belkan, and they love to stir shit up. Pitting nations against other nations is a particular favorite of theirs, along with developing hyper-advanced technology.
That's right. I'm Belkan, born and raised. My country is gone now. Rather than surrender to its enemy, Belka detonated 7 nuclear weapons on its own soil. My people scattered around the globe, living in the shadows of other countries. We had a new purpose, to breed wars. The theory was that through war, we could achieve our destiny and our revenge. I had just finished inputting Mihai's data when his granddaughter came in. She destroyed the only copy I had of the information I squeezed out of him. The girl loved Mihai. No one knew more than her just how hard I pushed her grandfather for that data, how much I made him sacrifice in the process. I promised his granddaughters that his efforts were not in vain, that it could end this terrible war. But in the end, it only caused more chaos and despair. We were responsible for all this damage, all this tragedy. Now, we were going to pay for it. The Arusians, once our allies, would see to that. I had lost the drive to continue my work, even before I noticed Mihai's granddaughters eyeing me with suspicion that one day. I should have stopped then, for all our sakes. Mihai's granddaughter tossed the gun aside. She said if she resorted to killing, she'd just end up like the rest of us. And by us, she meant everyone, including the princess. Like me, the princess was afraid to look into the girl's eyes. She knew that by encouraging her people, she kept the war going. Mihai and his granddaughter were victims of it. And now, they too were paying the price.
Is this for Belka? Or for Arusia? My grandfather had only one wish, to continue soaring through the endless skies. That was the only place where he felt alive. But I don't even have a country to call home, let alone the sky. The Black Forest, the lake, they are no longer mine. Even though those lands were once cherished by my late mother. We have to learn to put that sense of nostalgia behind us and behave like mature adults.
My homeland. She's right. It feels so far away now. The woman with the rifle approached me. She was focused on more pressing issues.
I checked the computer. All of the data on the legendary ace had already been installed.
No, I pulled it before it was completed. However, there are 2 aircraft that are already scheduled to be manufactured based on that data.
We must destroy the factory.
This isn't the only one. There are more facilities just like it, and the 2 planes containing the data will be manufactured at one of those facilities.
So, this place runs on solar power that the space elevator generates, right? How about the others?
We can destroy the space elevator and cut the power to them. First things first, let's take this one out.
I'll show you which locations to target.
I stood there, thinking about that mural by the factory's entrance. Harling commissioned it to be painted. I realized that in the background, behind the dancing figures, the artist had painted several space elevators. I understand now. The space elevator wasn't designed to exploit Arugia after all.
Good. And afterwards, we'll bring down the space elevator itself. No matter why it was built, right now, it's the root of this chaos.
I wonder...
Yes?
I wonder which path you would choose. When looking at Harling's mirror,
let's get the briefing started.
We've done enough air operations. Just let us go home.
There's no path for us to get home. Whatever direction you fly, it'll be right into a hail of enemy fire. Earlier, we received a communication via the partially restored general network. Here is what it contained. Apparently, the Arugian radicals have gathered around the space elevator, as it's a source of energy. Give the warmongers a powerful energy source, and you give them the luxury to keep on fighting. In response to this, people from both Osea and Arugia have joined forces and will take down the final arsenal bird in a saturation attack from the air and the sea. Once that's achieved, they'll take the space elevator from the aggressors.
Has the source been verified?
It could be fake. I hear you. Take a look at what's written at the end. Hey, dumbass, if you want to bring the world back from the brink, go to the lighthouse and see the future.
Dumbass?
Sounds familiar.
Certainly does. It's from those guys we met in Tyler Island, the 444 squad. It's a message to all those looking to end the war. But I also think it's a message for Trigger.
Guess we'll do what it says.
Okay. Well then, I'm thinking we go roast that damn bird.
Looks like we're all on the same page. It's time to end this war. Time to fly, guys. Let's go get that arsenal bird.
We need help! Don't let him damage more! Show him what the erosion, no, what fighter pilots are made of!
Thanks. I owe you.
No sweat.
Get into formation. We have the numbers.
Well, if it isn't the LRSSG, looks like our luck has turned. LRSSG, you will secure air superiority. There are Arugian aircraft in the Coalition, so they have been ID'd as friendly via the data link.
Just confirmed it.
The Arugian government aircraft, including drones, will show up as hostiles. You two aces, I'm thinking it's time to show us what you've got.
We don't have two anymore. Guess nobody told them.
That's quite true, Count. It's not just two. Wiseman trained his squad well. Everyone still entered as an ace. He'd be proud of you all.
To all of you who have gathered here, regardless of your country, this is headquarters of the Ocean Army Southern Command. Wait, you can forget that designation. We are a coalition formed exclusively for the sole purpose of taking down the Arsenal Bird. Wait until we're ready to strike the Arsenal Bird in unison.
Roger. Rox, speaking on an open channel. The enemy can hear everything he's saying. There's no other choice. The Arugian aircraft are in the coalition as well.
Third Squadron and Rigel Squadron of the Arugian Air Force. We're here on our own. Broadcaster, we're entering your airspace.
Mr. X's crew.
Count, ease up. Engagement is forbidden.
Don't worry, I know. We need every bird we can call upon. Even if they were flying with the guy that killed Wiseman. Some of their squadrons are in weird formations.
They have manned aircraft and UAVs in plain route.
All this just to keep the war going. The UAVs were sluggish once the leader went down.
I thought as much. We have trains without fear.
eventually. Okay, commencing transmission. I'm speaking over both terrestrial broadcasting and video transmission networks. It's not important why. First, our goals. Destroy the space elevator. Second, we want power to the drone factory cut in order to put a stop to all the war and chaos that its products cause. And last, we want to bring an end to this pointless war that is giving rise to a state of anarchy. Let me tell you what's going on right now. The land is overrun with refugees who have lost their homes. This is no isolated incident. In spite of that, the war continues to rage overhead.
Some coalition as this turned out to be, huh? They'll keep talking to me once the war's over, too. You can bet on it. We need something or someone to guide us.
Are the primitive Russians rebels or what?
They're rebels, but I'm sure it's more complicated than that. Brush up on current events later. Focus on the enemy.
Copy that. Take a look. See that line continuing above the horizon? The cable goes up to the sky as far as the eye can see. Not many people know this, but the space elevator is the world's tallest transmission tower. In theory, its radio waves cover exactly half the globe. We've jacked up signal in order to reach out to you.
Together. I'm failing out!
to take down the space elevator, but it's not like we can just go out there and chop it down. At the top of the windbreak, six location markers have been set in place. They monitor distortions in the space elevator. Those are the locations we need to target. If the sensors go bad, the elevator's observation system will think the elevator has fallen. Until its safety can be confirmed, all microwaves will be stopped.
Oh, I get it.
I was gonna do it myself.
Helios launched from the Arsenal burn. Five seconds. Three, two, impact now. Caught that. It's all over. Arriving in 10 seconds. 5 seconds to arrival.
Missile.
Two. Inbound.
Damn it! I think
Shepard's too. Trigger got a sub-propeller.
Up until a few moments ago, my friend was here. pulses around the space elevator. Surrender now, we will not attack.
We should hold them off until support arrives. Our units surrender. You guys better not throw away your lives either.
Wait there, Princess. We'll get you down.
Don't worry about me. Please, just take care of the refugees. I'll parachute down. What?
Warning. Incoming bogey.
Are those the drones we saw at that factory?
I'm coming down. I'll see you on the ground.
No, wait!
Enemy on my six! Those guys are bad news. Trigger, boss, do something!
Strider 2, missile inbound! Cosette! What?
This isn't the time for that! Avril, they're headed this way. Get the refugees to safety now.
Strider 2, you're hit. Are you all right?
Still breathing. I won't be flying much longer, though.
There's an Ocean carrier a few kilometers to the west. It ran aground and was abandoned. It won't be easy, but it's the only place you got.
Trigger, escort your wingman. Let's get to that carrier. That's all we can do. Nice work. You pulled off a perfect landing. Well, we're okay for the moment. Now the real challenge begins.
I can't just snap my fingers and make a plane. Believe me, I wish I could. Right now, we needed one. Bad. When we were coming over on the boat, I remember seeing an aircraft carrier. That gave me an idea. The Admiral Anderson. The name of an old sailor. When the first drone started attacking, this ship wasn't ready for battle yet. It was still in the dock, getting all rigged up. So they rushed to get her ready. I know about Anderson. In the previous Ocean War, he was the commander of a ship that sent out the last fleet of jets. They say the deck was sloping so bad as it sank, the last plane barely made it off. Those fighters ended the war. That story gives me a little bit of hope, especially at a time like this. We're all in the same boat, like it or not. If this war keeps going on like it is, it'll be the end of everything. The military loaded this thing to the rafters with planes. Some were fighters that were going to be delivered to bases in occupied territory. It was hit before it could complete the mission. Jackpot. The hangars were loaded with goodies. This scrap queen's got work to do.
Trigger, everyone, listen up. The operation was a success. Erujian defense forces have been neutralized and all Arsenal birds are down. However, those two new drones buzzing around have royally screwed up our plans. The Ocean and Erujian Coalition's air forces are in a sorry state thanks to them. We might not even have any viable aircraft left. According to the Scrap Queen, the drones are trying to use the Space Elevator's transmission capabilities to send their data to drone manufacturing plants across the continent. They're trying to strengthen their numbers. What's worse, their data contains a depth of war experience, so the newer aircraft will be more tactically advanced. If that's the case, this war will never end. We need to take both drones down no matter what it takes. We'll do it. So we have homes to go back to. Well, the Scrap Queen's on our side. She says she can make any aircraft fly. This is our final mission. Trigger, let's go. We've got a goddamn war to end.
Hey, can you hear me? That craft is in peak condition. I even buffed up the canopy for a nice shine, so you can really see the sky. Take care, Trigger. When you get back, let me know what you saw.
Let me see that. Trigger? Wish I could have flown with you.
A dinged up plane and an injured pilot would only slow you down. I feel for him now.
Take care. Whatever happens, it ends here. The outcome's mostly up to him.
Oh, this is the guy? Oh, yeah. He's the one who took off just now.
With us.
I'm seeing they're sticking around, too.
I don't care what country anyone's from. What counts is knowing who the real enemy is. Right, guys?
Affirmative. And I think everybody here knows the score. We all know who to follow. Commence mission. All aircraft, follow Trigger.
Roger that. Understood.
All right.
Understood.
The space elevator is able to broadcast and communicate. The information infrastructure down, it's the only place capable of wide area data transmission. The drones are waiting for it to power up again.
Clever little bastards.
Go leader to Longcaster. UAV is confirmed in direction of travel. Engaging the bandits.
All aircraft converge on Skull Squadron. Surround and shoot them down.
Strider 3, copy. Let's do it, Hushin.
Welcome.
UAV reacting. Damn, they're fast. All aircraft stay sharp. Intercept now. Skull 2, lost. Damn it, that was quick.
I've never seen anyone fly this fast. Provide support.
Friendly lost. Another confirmed down.
Damn it.
The UAVs are equipped with laser weaponry. Watch where their nose is pointing.
Is that the prototype that Wiseman was talking about?
I can't hear
a sec. Is it just me, or is that thing trying to read Trigger's reactions?
Look, it's observing Strider 1. It's like it's trying to...
Trigger.
is hollow, and there's no ceiling all the way up. Not sure if my bird can handle it, though.
Fly! I know you can make it! I'll attempt a belly landing. Get out of here! Everyone's waiting for you!
I wanted to wait until I had less fuel, but I have no choice. Attempting to land. I don't think my plane will make it. Anyway, here goes. Come on, baby, stay with me just a bit more.
Should we send in an evac team?
We can't give up. We have to wait.
Can you hear me? We're all waiting. A world of darkness needs a light to shine. We're waiting for that beacon of light.
Look, it's Trigger. Strider 1 has returned to radar.
I did it!
That's our Trigger!
He's a damn hero!
No doubt. You're better than me.
We're Strider 2. Damn it. Does anyone have eyes on Count?
Wish y'all could have seen that.
You damn fool. What's your position?
Watching Trigger climb. I guess it's my fate to watch from down below.
Yeah, well, we're all in the same boat there.
Yeah, well, I guess we are.
We're sending help. Give us your coordinates.
Directly under the space elevator. Elevation is minus 500 meters.
Minus? Hey, Trigger. You dumbass. Tell me something. What color's the sky up there?
On our way back from our 7-year mission to the asteroid belt. I can't tell you how proud I am to be the first to land at this
spaceport. Wait, what was that transmission?
This is Captain Kei Nagase of the spaceship Pilgrim 1. The ocean of stars in our galaxy is finally within our reach. To the pilot who generously gave this spaceship a place to dock, we are forever grateful. The universe lies ahead of us, waiting to be discovered. And now, at last, we have a gateway to ascend to it, over and over again.
It's all coming together for me. Today was the day, the moment of her return.
I salute the pilot who gave us all a future.
To skies unknown. The path to mankind's vast future remains standing, Granddad. The refugees built a settlement for themselves at the base of the space elevator. A humanitarian mission from Yuktuvania airdropped some supplies for them again today. Thanks to the princess, the whole world was pitching in to help these people. Handing out the relief supplies would have been a perfect gig for that anarchist dude. But since he's dead now, the job went to the guy from Belka, George. I guess Tabloid got that new system he wanted in the end. Mihai's granddaughters are helping out too. Mihai. That cranky old geezer's here with us, too.
I never wanted to create anything, and now here I am, clinging to life. Watching as my grandchildren and their generation make a new future for themselves and the world. Is this my punishment, then? All I do is lie here, wasting away. I'll never know the freedom of flying the open skies ever again. I've been grounded, and my wings have been clipped.
You know what having peace in the world means? It's being able to die in your own bed at a ripe old age. Peace is what those girls are working so hard for here. We got a bunch more refugees today. And the princess? She's looking to the stars. Dark blue. To the heavens and beyond. Can you hear me?
Tu te souviens de nos fleurs préférées qui chantaient tout près de nous du jour de ta déclaration d'amour, les mains pleines de pensées, plus même d'entendre nos pleurs. Yeah.
you in the backyard, baby, with a barbecue blazing on a Saturday. Yeah. House party jumping so loud, Chris Thal always sipping when he sleep. And he say, can I kick it? Yes, you can I kick it? Yes, you can I kick it? Yes, we can.